Let's see what happens this time. She can't even take 2 steps. Alright. Do I have a way out? Do I have an escape? Nope. Damn. Alright. E6. I just have to figure out how to leave. Hey. Yeah, I'm currently stuck in a dungeon trying to figure out how to leave without dying, because I don't think that's an option. But basically, the dungeon is the office of the guys who make Hello Kitty, if that makes any sense. And I have to find my way to the roof where my brother is possessed by a demon. I swear to God that I'm not making a lick of that up. Damn it. And yes, that is a sentient vending machine kicking my ass. There we go. Alright, let's see. How the fuck do I get out of here? Yeah, my friend told me that basically I'm at a point in the game where if I don't do a bunch of side shit now, I'm never getting the chance. I can't become the vending machine. But I can steal from him. Let's see. And shakedown. Problem is, if I'm not careful. Oh, yeah, also, one of my party members is Sailor Moon. I forgot to mention that part. I don't know why, but she is. There we go. And let's just kill you. All right. Hold on. Oh, that's what I was forgetting to doing. Hold on. I use a program on my end to fuck a bit with the audio settings, too. I'd forgotten to do that. Thanks for reminding me. All right. Yeah, looks like it should be good. I don't know. Yeah. Is there a way to leave this building without dying? Or do I just have to die? Because the lowest floor it's letting me go to is 86. And I don't think I could survive jumping from that high. Can I steal anything from you? Eh. And shake down that. Oh, Christ, not this shit again. Hold on. Yeah, I didn't change any audio settings in the OBS, so I don't know why it's not recording the game. Give me a sec. Okay, I see the problem. Let me try something. What? Okay, that didn't work. Yeah, I don't know why it's not playing any audio. No. on. Yeah, I know, and I didn't change anything. That's on OBS's end. Damn it. And my controller died. Hold on. Okay. I love it when computer programs change their fucking settings without asking. Properties. Better? Okay, yeah, it looks like it's picking, OBS is picking it up. Is it recording it? Okay. Okay. Oh. Let's just go ahead and rename my stream. There we go. All right, everyone's dead. Yeah, though, is there actually a way for me to leave here, or do I just have to die? Because if I gotta die, I'll just die. I'm only gonna lose 6 grand. It's closer to 6 because you steal the 800 and then you gain about half that after you beat her. Fucking dungeon, because I got it beaten up until the boss. Let's go. Oh yeah, I couldn't figure out that password. Got that one. Let's check the next floor up. Nope, I don't want to go to 86, I want to go to 88. There we go. Thank you. stick combo. Alright. Okay. I love it when they give the enemy the ability to reflect and counter physical attacks. Oh, thanks for the host, Doc Nog. I'm sorry, I can't take your name seriously, though. Huh? And he's gone. Oh well. Murray, talk to that guy. What's down here? Talk to you. Get away. Let's see, 89. I mean, at least if they gave you an option just to go to floor number one, that would have been nice. Already got that item. Oh yeah, Ryan, when you weren't here the other day, I figured out how to get the light bulb for this area so I don't have to come back for it. So I am learning. Talk to you and leave? What biolab? There's no biolab up here. Oh, yeah, I know what he's talking about. Those things I had to scare to get the light bulb. Is that one chest, so I just gotta find it at some. Well, that didn't work. Alright. There's gotta be a way I can get this open. Let's see. Nope. That won't work. Can't scare it. Maybe set it on fire. Nope. Eh, worth a shot. That's just how I drop down a floor. What was over here? The air conditioner. Nah, I think the flying cat just guards the whole building, because he'll pop up everywhere and kick my ass if I'm not careful. Because I love it when they give the random monsters the ability to reflect and counter. Because it works so good with Wobbuffet. Oh well. See what's out here. Got you. Yeah, there's the light bulb. And we're gone. Yes, I did. I don't know why. why I'm looking for chests. I already know which one I didn't get, so, eh. This bat, so this was another dead end. I should be on 87 if I'm not mistaken. So let's just drop down to 86 and see where that takes me. Yeah, and then that just drops me back here. There's no way out, dude. I'm stuck. Fuck it. I'm gonna have to go down swinging. There we go. RIP 6 grand. You were too good for this world. How much do I have left? 4 grand, so let's go ahead and just dump that in the... Actually, I'll hit the ATM here instead and just deposit all that so I don't have to worry about losing it a second time. What can I do? I got notes. Note of the spider cave. Fuck it, Bird Mountain. Let's go there. What's the worst that'll happen? Jesus Christ, I'm gonna die. Yeah, I know. Wildflower. The Henson Company proudly presents Sesame Street. Punch that bird. Money, so I don't, so I can buy items. Bank is back here. Some good luck, but let's do it. I have no idea why this nightmare demon has to be in the friggin' starting area, though. That's some Xenoblade level shit. Like, yeah, there's just a level 99 to 100 monster in the first area of the game. Just don't attack it, you'll be fine. Even though they know everyone's gonna attack it because they're idiots. form of an angry bear. Okay. Oh yeah, no. I'm not going in that spider cave until I can curb check it. Or just nuke it from orbit. Either or, really. And I'm probably ready for this area since I keep getting green, you don't have to fight these guys notifications. I think that's the first time that's happened since I came here. Last time I had about 50-50 split, so I should be fine. Yep. Skills, Jimmy. Nope. Imagination. Now I have a reliable heal. Because the game took away my healer and hasn't given her back, and it's been like 6 hours. Please, game, I just want to see my mom again. Please. There we go. Okay, and then should be able to take these guys out pretty easily. And have Taka perform a fucking combo on this parasite monster. Half the fun of this game is just being underleveled for an area and wandering into a nightmare-fueled boss fight that you really shouldn't be fighting. But the game hates you, so they make you fight it anyway. Thank you. Not this shit again. God damn it. Every fucking time. I'm alive. I'm alive because Lars is a fucking meat tank of a man. Doesn't die or know how to. Fortunately, I'm down to my last alarm clock already. Because this boss just hits the insta-nuke button. Oh well. Good thing I saved right before it. Yeah, sure. I'll take advice. It's kind of hard to not die from the insta-nuke. Though he could at least do some real damage. Vitamins. There we go. Since he's gonna drop me off, let's switch to the pumpkin. This is Jimmy and the Pulsating Existential Nightmare. You'll see why in a moment. That's no normal bird. And yes, one of my party members is Sailor Moon for reasons unknown even to myself. Didn't make much of a difference. Jimmy still almost died, but hey, progress. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, being confused is normal. Oh, thank God. Okay, I can work with this. Sailor Moon powers activate. God damn it, I just realized Hitomi can reflect magical attacks. I probably should start using that. See, I'm making progress now. That's good. I can work with progress. Lord knows I don't have anything else to work with right now. Because the fucking nerf herbs killed it for me! Fuck you, game! I win! Kinda. and Jimmy received no experience points because he was unconscious. God fucking damn it. What do I get? Barbed wire. Spellbook that I probably needed going into that fight. I would think I did a good job since the game beat itself for me. Let's see. Might be useful. Let's just give. Up here? Nope. Just a nice view. And I still can't just walk away from this place. I have to actually explore my way out. God damn it. Oh well. I can knock that off my list of things to do. Creepy Wind Mountain. Alright. Next up, we're gonna go kill a dragon. Yeah, that was the plan. Alright, let's go. How much money do I have? $6,500. Cool. Okay, yeah, I have to teleport there. Still want to figure out how to get to that place, but eh. Ever chip. And there goes literally all of the money I just made, spent on healing items to go get it more money that'll probably be worth less. And now to do what all vampires are known to do. Travel through a mirror. Because... reasons? there is still a treasure chest somewhere in here that I'm gonna have to find when I'm done. Yeah. Death comes to those who wake us, who wake the sleeping dragon. Okay, Lars, kick the dragon. What? Kick the dragon. Oh my god. I bought the wrong items. I bought 10 vitamins. God damn it. We're somehow holding our own with just these two. I actually don't know how I've lasted this long in this fight. I think it's just because Lars heals faster than he can take damage. Because look, he took 115 damage that turn, and then he regained 130-something. No, I'm not dead yet. Damn. That went far better than it should have. I'm not gonna lie. I should not have been able to get it to half health when half my party got insta-gibbed. Again. Alright. Let's try that again. If this doesn't work this time, I'm gonna go off and try something else. Tomi had a way to double her damage output, though. That'd be hilarious. You fucking dragon. People think I don't know what I'm doing. Joke's on them. god, oh fuck, oh god, oh fuck, oh god, oh fuck. I got arrogant. I got very arrogant and did stupid. Okay, Lars. It's all on you, fat boy. Let's go. Holy shit. Damn it! I was this close to winning. Oh well. Yeah, I know. I could have won that. The problem was the dragon was faster than Lars. As such, I couldn't have won that. And then have Punch Tanaka live up to his goddamn name and punch each other. Alright, there we go, and that should bring me up higher. Gotcha, bitch. Now let me just go ahead and return the favor for you. Heal Jim Jamboree. Mm-hmm. I think Tanaka's gonna die here. Yep. Nuke the fucker, please. Hey, Wombat. Killed the boss, went to go fight another boss. Now I'm beating the shit out of a dragon. Save me. See, the problem with beating bosses with half my party down and no healing items to revive them from the dead is that they're dead and I have no way to revive them, so they don't get any of the experience points. Cool. Alright, time to explore the rest of this castle and find that last treasure chest that I missed. Take the book because I don't have Andrew. Fuck. I don't own Assassin's Creed Unity. The last game I played in that series was 4. Actually, no, that's wrong. I have Origins, but that's only because I got it free with my mic. And it's on Uplay, so eh. Yeah, I can only imagine it's because the fucking main centerpiece of that game caught fire. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. At least I'm assuming it's Andrew. It just said someone really smart, and he's a smart boy. Can I leave through the front door? Nope. Let's check the basement. This entire game is fucking weird, man. Like, this game is typically 16-bit-esque. Then just for some reason, this entire world is 8-bit. Also, vampires can travel through mirrors now because God can no longer help you. That's done. Head back to King's March and heal real quick. Not bad for going into a fight with exactly one healing item, one resurrection item, and 5 MP items. Frankly, I don't think I should have won that. Alright, let's go this way, back to the clubhouse, and then from there I'm heading to the giant's feet cave. Oh yeah, I know about the crying girl under the beach house, if that's what you're talking about. I just don't know how to get her. I do not know how to get her to interact with me. Yeah, if you're talking about this chick. Alright, I'll wander around a bit. Just hanging out's all I gotta do. Let's see, castle level bonus area boss I can get rid of. I finished the weird cave of puzzle and the path of enlightenment. So am I just supposed to stand here for a while or something? Literally supposed to be moving around. Around this guy or the fish cannery? Alright. So is it supposed to be a random encounter fight or something? He killed himself. Damn it, Jimmy, you are a literal bear. Stop being afraid of women in bikinis, you dick. Am I supposed to be defeating these people or just running from them? Because I feel like there's something I'm missing here. And it doesn't help the guy I have with clean getaway starts off fucking scared, so I can't even attack with him. I think I did. Yeah, I talked to everybody. So what is this even supposed to do? Trigger an event, trigger a boss? I feel like there's something you're not telling me about this. Thank you. wish I had a way to get up into that condo and up to that light bulb, but I'll probably get that later. Hold on a sec. They said a big wave, so maybe I'm... back and hear that story again. I feel like I am missing something. Alright, let's see. Yeah, sure, yada yada. Long time ago, school trip. Dumping trash and stuff. Ocean couldn't really swim, kept bugging her. Waves, made her fall over and she got pulled by the undertow. Major League scandal. Near the beach was covered in trash and junk. Someone who looked just like her was seen walking out of the ocean. Okay, yeah, there's not really much I can do to help trigger this event. Unless I'm supposed to be moving the trash. What's up? Okay, so I am doing it wrong. Alright. So I just grind through random encounters, I guess. Why are all these beach assholes beating up a child? Two people leveled up. Now I need to go fucking heal. So is this just basically shiny chaining in this game? Okay. Did I do it? Could have told me this was a boss fight, because, you know, no healing items. Prevent drowning.
Lars. Thank you.
What, do you mean stuns? I mean, I'd stun them by punching them in the face, so... Am I supposed to use a skill or something that resurrects the dead? Or the unconscious, rather? Is that what the punchline to this joke is? You counter it and or the reflect, obviously. So I fucking stunned them. I already said that. Problem is, I got one weapon good for that shit, and it kinda tanks my fucking physical attacker. I lost Buck like 15 hours ago. I don't fucking remember. Let's see, what did I have when I lost Buck? Well, I had all of my forms, so that doesn't narrow it fucking down. I looked at almost everything in the last 5 minutes. That does not narrow it down. If I said the thing out loud, you could have said, yeah, dumbass, that thing. Thank you. I think you just tried to strangle that metaphor to death. Honestly, I'm half expecting it to just be use pep talk on her and bring her back to life or something stupid like that. Or maybe use an alarm clock on her to resurrect her. Even then, I don't think that'd work. I tried grifting her. There was no items. Oops. Not skills. Just a list of what I can do outside of battle. They're different skills and I words. Different skills I can equip onto Jimmy. There are different abilities the different forms can learn, Okay. Not learn. Supposed to be a skill I can equip or something? Oops, wrong character. No equipment. Fucking punch. No? Why? So I can equip different character skills onto different things or something? Oh, I already had that, whatever. So if it just has that skill, hmm. So that there are specific skills that the enemy has, or that my other party members have, or something? Is that what you're on about? That just go back to stunning them and preventing them from attacking, though? So I just have to stun her to keep her from attacking. Is that what you're trying to tell me? Remember the question. Just let me fight as Jimmy so I can fucking run away. There we go. They were unable to because the man with clean getaway is a fucking coward who can't handle people in a fucking bikini. Jesus Christ. There we go. To prevent it from happening, you need to stop it from happening, which that's just circular logic. To do something, to stop something from happening, you need to stop it from happening. The reason I even used the stun as much on Buck is because he had the, because he basically could do it the majority of the time. No, I have skills. Just run from the battle, Jimmy. It's not that hard. You're just Can I please just smack Jimmy upside the head for being an idiot? It's not fucking equipment. So what was I using? Fish knife. Yeah, well, too bad. He doesn't have a choice, because they're trying to murder him. The child's initial reaction should be to run away. This is why all thoughts need to be punched. They'll just randomly attack you at the beach and try to beat you up with a hula hoop. At the skills for every form except what you're looking for. What am I supposed to do as Jimmy? I looked at the skills of every other form. Talking about DOT, like damage over time or something? No, you aren't, because I haven't said that yet. I have to rely on the fucking bird? Actually, does that even work on boss fights? No, I refuse. Fuck the bird. I'm not using the goddamn bird. Fuck that. Fuck this. Fuck everything. Yeah, because the bird form fucking sucks. If I had a way to get consistent stuns on a different form, I would. Run away, Jimmy, and Daddy won't have to get his belt again. You seem to not realize literally the only thing I have ever used the bird form was getting over gaps, and when I figured out that the fucking ghost can do that and be useful. Is it a little too? So it is. So it is. Fuck it. Let's goddamn level grind. How about that? Ha ha ha, very funny. Deadpan's an idiot. Yeah, everyone knows. I don't exactly make it a secret. You think with how many times I've beaten these three to unconsciousness that they'd stop coming? God damn it. I don't want to grind this guy all the way to level 50 just so that I can get the skill on a useful character. Fuck. Fuck. Hold up, what? Thank you. Yeah, and then it decided to not work because it immediately made me fucking scared. And so I couldn't do anything. Drowning, so I'm on a time limit. Let's see how it goes. Ah, okay. I'm just gonna have to keep spamming annoying squawk for the rest of the fight, really. Why do you have to do that? Stupid bird, you made me look bad! Jesus. I mean, this fight's mostly just all itself right now, considering she's dumb enough to lock herself in a fear loop of ours. See how this goes. Thank you. Yeah, frankly, I should not be doing this well right now, stuns notwithstanding. So let's go level grind somewhere else. Actually, let's go the other way. Because at this point, I really have nothing to gain by being here. That won't just result in the beach babe trying to murder me again. My money. Back to town. Buy some escape items and then go level grind in the tower for a little bit. Can't buy them from you. Thank you. Oh, no, I'm level grinding to get money, too, and to get the bird to higher level. Because I need healing items. Yeah. Especially since I got a fountain right here, so it should be pretty easy to take him out and get some money. I just love the image of Tanaka beating up a fucking vending machine. Bitch better have my money! Dead. I'm so glad I figured out how to get that fucking thing unfrozen, I swear to God. Take it. Shit. Yeah, I know. What do you think I'm going for? It's hyperactivity, I think it's only level 5. No, hyperactive is level 5. We'll be right back.
Yeah, it also helps that when I'm trying to get the Tomy up to a level where she can use that Sailor Moon move four times before running out of MP. Jesus Christ, Jimmy's already moved up to the second fastest party member. Fuck me. Yeah, that would do it. Yeah. He's a speedy boy. My bird's level 10. How am I doing on money? Almost 10 grand. God damn it. Everyone's still alive. Yay, go team. Wow, another marvelous coin that I can't use because they're fucking worthless. Honk. Neither can handle age, or can handle age. I don't get why there's a character limit in fucking Twitch. your last message just cut off the last sentence. Your last message ended with neither can H. Hold on, I might just be OBS. I'm gonna check. There we go. Some Tanaka Roddy. Yeah, I think Rad Ghost is a reference to a YouTuber named Nitro Rad, who, as far as I'm aware, is the only reason this game got any coverage at all before launch. Because I know his video has more views than the trailer. Which I'm not complaining, I like Nitro Rad, he's a cool dude. I mean, Jet, it would be on the wiki if you already, you can just go over there and check. I'm probably wrong, though. Yay, Lars has leveled up. Let's do one more fight. That'll get me at 1500, or 15,000 rather. Bitch. And then Lars kills the little robot girl by sitting on its face. Emergency exit. Okay, good. Now I should have enough money to buy some items and fight that evil ghost bitch. Is there not like a trivia section at the bottom that says what it was inspired by? Admittedly, that's pretty cool, though. I mean, I don't know. Maybe Casey did say it and I just missed it. That's why I'm asking. I don't know.
I'll just tweet at him when I'm done. I don't ask. I might just be making connections that don't exist. Okay, I know I can buy some alarm clocks at Home Flower because for some reason there isn't the option to buy them here. Because he brought attention to this game back when it was still a free-to-play demo. On, what's the page? Game Jolt, I think. Was it Game Jolt? Might have been Itched. I don't remember. One or the other. This was 2 or 3 years ago. So I've beaten the dragon, I've beaten the bird, I'm gonna beat this bitch. How many more secret bosses have I missed? Because you said you had a list of them. Johnny Knive. No, Big, whatever his name is. The artist formerly known as Big Enormous. Okay, you're gonna have to tell me where they are, but not how to get to them, I guess. One of them this bitch? Because as far as I can tell, I think I've taken care of every other boss that I'm aware of. Who knew to escape from people, all I had to do was be faster than them. I've already saved a couple of times. Go ahead.
Hold on.
That's not right. No, not that. I think one of my accounts, I think my Ubisoft account got hacked. Hold on, I'm actually gonna have to take care of this. I feel like this is a valid excuse. Well, I mean, if they're sending me an email at about a fucking change of email address, I think it's safe to assume I've been pwned. Yeah, I went through a while back and I got a password manager that I changed a lot of my passwords. I must have forgotten about Ubisoft. No, it's not the same password. Like, they're trying to change the email account attached to my Ubisoft account. There we go. Oh yeah, no, they can't. I'm just changing the password to be safe. Yeah, I like password managers a lot. Also, the Ubisoft login is fucking stupid because you go to log in, you put in your information correctly, it says you failed because you didn't do the CAPTCHA, even though the CAPTCHA wasn't there when you first tried to log in. It's fucking stupid. Yep. I just wish their two-step authorization bullshit worked on phones and not just email, but hey, what can you do? Alright. Oh yeah, no, I just use a password generator that generates at least a 16-character password and lets me add in, say, digits, special characters, shit like that. I typically make it as long as they let me. I mean, I would prefer just to write them all down, but I don't have a piece of paper. There's not a piece of paper big enough in the world. Yeah, the problem is I only ever sign into Uplay when I want to play Rainbow Six Siege, so I kind of just forgot about it. Because it's fucking Uplay, man. Who fucking uses Uplay? Alright, but yeah, that's fixed. Only problem is now I've got like 20 fucking emails from Ubisoft about every step of the way in my fucking inbox that I'm gonna have to go through and spend 10 seconds manually deleting. And fuck that noise. I mean, writing them down and keeping them hidden somewhere in my room isn't that bad of an idea, considering this room is such a fucking mess, I'm the only one who'd be able to find it. And even then, that's 50-50 odds. Oh shit, my dad's birthday's in a few days and I still haven't gotten him anything yet. Fuck, I'll probably just buy him a bottle of decent vodka or something. Hey, if you're still playing ESO, I got a code for the Elsewhere closed beta, I guess. I didn't remember signing up for it, but I guess it was just for everyone who played. Oh no, this isn't like a sticky note. This is literally balled up, shoved in a drawer on the other side of the room underneath 8 different fucking massive things. Things that look like a junk drawer. Besides, you've seen my handwriting. Even if they were to steal it, they wouldn't be able to fucking read it. No, what I do is write out the password, and then I run it through a random cipher. Oh, my dad's birthday is on the 20th. No, 21st, rather. Sorry. So in 4 days. So I wasn't going to interrupt anything. It's just like, oh yeah, shit, it's this week. Fuck. Will you people... stop throwing your fucking frisbees at us! I mean, yes, but actually, still fucking annoying. Why do they keep attacking me? What do they have against me? I'm just a small bird. I'm just a small bird that's also a record player for some fucking reason. Probably. Still annoying, though. Just let me go full Ghostbusters game. That's all I want. Okay, if they're playing frisbee though, why are they following me all the way up and down the beach? Like, is it too much to want to just kill a member of the Drowned Doom? Come on. Honk.
Gnarly way, bruh.
Especially when they don't even attack Jimmy, they just beat up his friends and uncle and his uncle's high school girlfriend, which is really creepy, Lars. Who knows? I mean, I'm kind of glad Rad Ghost isn't here for no other reason than the fact that I get to keep avoiding it. So I really need to figure out how to get up to that light bulb. Probably a form I get later or something. Thank you.
Why is this bitch not showing up? It normally isn't this hard to get her to pop. Jimmy, why? Your fear of women, of scantily clad women, is making this fight incredibly difficult, my friend. Yeah, all shiny Pokemon are hard to find. They're shiny. Oh well. Back to Trish Beach. I've noticed that if I get to the escape button fast enough, I can just escape from the fight before it happens. Because I somehow doubt this bitch is harder to find than a shiny. She actually has the 1 in 500 something odds. Please don't tell me she has the 1 in 500 something odds or whatever it is. Tired of this game. Please just help a birdie out. That's not what I meant. That is not what I meant. Try this again. Eventually it'll happen. I swear, game, please. I've got full items, I got full Chaka Colas, and I got four revives, so I should be fine. I feel like the bird should also be able to learn gnarly getaway, or clean getaway rather. Yeah, I did. I hope. Yeah, no, I definitely did. But why would they design a boss you can only fight once? That doesn't make any sense. Let's just talk to this bitch again. Maybe it'll trigger the flag. I'll give it 5 fights. If it doesn't appear, I'll go do something else. 4. Well, fuck it, I'm out. I'm gonna go do some other shit instead. Let's see what my notes say I still can do. What? Figure that out when I'm done with this cave area. What, go drink in that bar? Alright, mute notes? What the fuck? I forgot about this. Fucking Euclid. Honestly, the creepiest part of this place is the fucking music. But at least I'm grossly overleveled. That's not gonna prepare me for the boss, I'm sure. That okay, the fuck is that, and how do I kill it? This is not where I came from. What the fuck was that? Why did the level just just skip? Oh god, I'm in the fourth dimension. Why, god, why? When you said non-Euclidean geometry, I thought you just meant the enemy designs. I didn't think you meant the fucking area. How the fuck? What? Huh? How did I get here? What the fuck? That's weird. Though, why did it teleport me halfway across the goddamn map? Oh no, I'm still in the cave. Okay. Fine, I'll go this way, game. How about that? God, this is giving me antechamber flashbacks, except I don't have a headache yet. Progress. What the fuck is this? Oh god, I hear something sloshing around. Okay. Okay, what the fuck was that? What the actual fuck? Well, this got cosmic horror-y something fucking fast. Oh shit, I didn't heal. Is it too late to say that I'm bad at math? And I feel like that's gonna be necessary here. Thank you.
place is fucking creepy. Ah, shit. Let's get Jimmy back on his feet. What the fuck? What is this game? What is this thing, game? Why do you do this to me? Can I shake him down and get something? What?
Thank you.
Yeah, I know, I kinda got dragged away at the last minute, with no warning. Again. Must be a day ending in Y. I mean, at least this time it was actually something important, so it was good. So I got that come for me, which is nice. So that cave was a literal nightmare hellscape. What am I doing on items? Eh, good enough. Actually, I can delete the Spanish.
Sealand temples because I did that last time. Back in there? Not really. I don't know what that thing was, but I'm gonna have to come back to fight that. Huh. Wonder why the bank closed. Oh well. Yeah, that was a nightmare hellscape, the likes of which I've never seen before, nor do I plan on going back to anytime soon. And by that I mean I'm gonna go find the other optional bosses and beat their asses first, because, oh god, why? That was some creepypasta, non-Euclidean fucking antechamber bullshit. Alright, now where are the other optional bosses I could have potentially missed? Pretty much completely done up here, so... need to find number four, though. Oh. Oh, fun. All right. Let's head back to town real quick and talk to Andrew, see if I can get him in my party real quick. I mean, at least check out the area so I know what I'm looking for and to have them on my notes. It was still worth a shot, if nothing else. Alright, let's see. Island forest. Okay, I can probably go to that island place later on, so I add that to my notes. Check the bee cave. Maybe that's where four wound up. You know what? Nah. Let's just go back to pretending that area never happened and leave it at that. I can't fight the knights, and I'm not gonna try to fight the knights because I'm gonna lose. But there's still some shit I can probably do here.
I win. Huh? The hell? What did I do? Did I just break reality with the power of my ass? What? Oh, yeah, no, I figured it was in the room. I'm just exploring because I'm trying to find number four. Since he's a nerd, he might be in a weird society. After all,
we gamers live in one.
That fucking meme is so stupid. Anything back here? Already opened that. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, 7. Alright, that shouldn't be too bad. And by someone's toys, I'm guessing you meant that chest I just popped open? Hey look, I found a glitch.
Since you could have done the toy thing without stopping the clock, I honestly do not remember.
Well, it stopped time, obviously. I just think it's kind of cool. Maybe it's just a bad pun or something. Also, I didn't realize that's what you meant by stealing someone's toys when I came here. That was just a happy coincidence. What's this? So I found... So I found two bosses here, right? So I found all three of the side bosses I wasn't supposed to know about. The two here, and I just want to see what the fuck this leads to. I'm ready to make a poor decision. Besides, I only have 200 bucks. It's not like I've got a lot to lose. What a stupid... Hi, Limmy. How are you doing? My bad. I was trying to take a screenshot of that, but... Oh well. A kilogram of steel is heavier than a kilogram of feathers. No, I hit the screen cap key and it didn't work. Oh my god, I'm in Alice in Wonderland! Wait, how do you know my name? I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna see what happens if I get that question right. This fucking game is amazing. Okay, so it's just a supposed to lose question. It's kind of bullshit, but whatever, I can respect that. Poor Mo Chair. Let's just see how this goes. I want to see how badly I'm going to get Ruffle stomped. Because of course in a game like this there was going to be an Alice in Wonderland level. I don't know what I was expecting. The question also is what? The question also is what? I'm able to run away from these fights, so I've got that going for me, which is nice. Oh, that's why. Alright. And back to horror. Okay. Mr. King Diamond, sir, I'm a fan of your work, but please stop murdering me. No, I had streamer mode turned on, and the problem was when I tried taking a screen cap, I hit the button I used. I have a streamer mode hotkey to F10, and Steam screenshots is F11, so I accidentally hit the wrong key, and I just forgot to turn it back on. Let me run. I'm here to die. Frankly, I'm surprised I've made it this far. Okay. Yeah, at this point, I'm just treating this like a meat grinder. I want to see what I'll find. How many years has it been since I arrived?
What the fuck is... Hey, man. Oh, goody. Harry Potter bullshit. I don't know how I've made it this far without dying. Oh, never mind. Stop dropping me through floors, you dick! Where the hell even am I? Oh, the cells. Okay. Hey, March Hare. God damn, this is the edgiest fucking Alice in Wonderland level I've played since I found out about the Alice Madness series. Thoughts. And of course, when I finally find interesting areas, he doesn't have any thoughts. Nice. Ew, is that some guy's skin? And that's just a dude's face. I see you, you caterpillar asshole. So I'm gonna go this way. I cannot go that way. I don't think the Queen of Hearts is capable of utter disdain. I think it's just resting in his face. How have I made it this far? You'd think by now I would have failed to escape and gotten ganked or something. But no. There we go.
Alright, let's keep going.
Oh goody, I'm back here. What a do, asshole. It's gonna be some horribly scarred monster. Oh, that's why I saved before I came in here. Is this supposed to be Legato? Like, am I in Legato or am I just in hell? I came here expressly to die, woman. You can't stop me. Double counter, bitch. So that never happened. So is time only frozen in Legato, or is it frozen everywhere? Okay there, Captain Beefheart. Christ. Just leave Legato and come back and we'll find out. Okay, so whatever it is, it only affects Legato. Is it because it's stupid? Cecilio, I fixed your button. Well, I mean, by your refusal to answer, that means it's a spoiler, so the answer is probably no. It's something really cool and awesome. I'm on to you, reverse psychology wizard man. I wonder what escaped from that cell. It couldn't have been the bird. It's got claws. Oh, I've got to use it to get through that door. Okay. Completely forgot about that. I win game. Your magic bullshit don't fool me. Alright. Oh yeah, no, I'm not going back in that nightmare hellscape anytime soon. Fuck that. My stand, the world! Hey, have you finished Diamond is Unbreakable yet, or no? I don't know what the episode the dub is up to. I know it's coming to the end, though. I can go fight the imaginary number hellscape, I can go fight the Alice in Wonderland hellscape, or I can go fight the unknown third option. Okay. Up. Okay. Yeah, I think this is going to be the last thing I do today. I ever make smart decision. Oh my god, I'm still in Wonderland. So that's where the mimics come from. I win. That's not how that works. No, I didn't. The ones between the frowns are mimics. The ones between the smiles are not. This one's a mimic. Yeah, no, I ain't having that bullshit game. I'm just gonna nuke this fucker. Tanaka-kun, please save me from this nightmare of which I cannot wake. Oh god, it's the fucking jester thing from, Well, I can't say it because you haven't played it. Well, I'm gonna die here. Well, glad to know my theory was completely wrong. So I'm gonna go back to the creepy demon giant cave. First, let's just hit up a bank. Get shit hammered, Mr. Barman. The answer is no. Thank you. Actually, I was just going to go back to the cave and call it there, because we're coming up on 4 hours, so it's about a good time to stop as any. Next time I'll pick up over there at the cave. Christ, this fucking game is long. Jesus fucking hell. Yeah, I took down the bird, I found a bunch of other shit, I leveled up. I learned the bird is actually useful. Fucking hell. Alright, yeah, see you guys later. I'll be back Friday to continue more of this horror.